So once again, the undisclosed location is undefeated. Minnesota Fighting Vikings offensive line coach Rick Dennison, who reportedly by ESPN was gone on Friday because he refused to get the COVID-19 vaccine. Now, remember, again, we are talking about the vaccine strictly from a football and NFL perspective. We're not giving judgment one way or the other, so you know, save your angry comments. Anyway, so that was what was reported by ESPN on Friday. Today, apparently the Vikings, they're working something out with Rick Dennison. Now, reportedly, Dennison will remain and will follow the NFL COVID guidelines. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that he got vaccinated. That doesn't mean that he isn't. Whatever it's going to be, like if he's vaccinated, he's going to be the normal offensive line head coach from what it sounds like. But if he doesn't get the shot, whether whatever reason he doesn't want to get it, whether he has hesitancy, whether it's religious, whether it's whatever. Anyways, if he doesn't get it, that will restrict what he can do with the offensive line. That means that Phil Rauscher, ipso facto, will become the offensive line coach since he's good to go. So he can be hands-on in meetings on the practice field. And if Dennison doesn't get vaccinated, I mean, he won't be able to do that under the current NFL COVID protocols. So it actually could work out. So if Dennison is in absentia as the, you know, senior offensive line consultant, Phil Rauscher, well, I think given his resume and also from what I've been hearing is that he does have a nice rapport, especially with the younger players. He is younger, so he can relate better. I think that it's the best of both worlds because we did want Rick Dennison fired. The way that it was reported on Friday, you know, did it sit well with a lot of people? I don't know. But either way, I think that Rauscher has talent. And I think that a lot of the young guys, because we did question Dennison's ability to develop young offensive linemen outside of Brian O'Neill, who's already stud when Dennison got here. What about Bradbury? He hasn't really ascended. Ezra Cleveland was a little hot or cold his rookie year. He was good in the run game. It was whatever in pass protection. And Dennison, give him credit. Like the offensive line run blocking was great. Pass protection, not so much. But either way, it was a little bit of a drama bomb. Also, it was reported that the source of the ESPN report was a member of the staff. So, I don't know. Loose lips sink ships, man. I mean, come on. But either way, I don't think this Dennison thing is over. But as of right now, just another chapter. On the eve of the actual start of training camp, because why the hell not? But your thoughts and our thoughts, let us know in the comments section. Skull, no production value.